the largest country in the world. It is a multinational country with more than 190 nationalities represented. Usually we say that Russian is not a nationality, but a state of mind. I was born in Russia, in the far north, a place where the temperature is minus 40 or minus 50 in winter is common. So that you understand how big our country is, half of the people don't even know where is it. And you definitely would not want to live there. But it is the most valuable territory, because it is the largest reserves of oil and gas in our country allocated.
About 35% of Russia's territory is located in the Arctic Circle. Russia regularly ranks first in various ratings of the least friendly countries in the world, but this is just a misunderstanding due to the difference in cultural codes. In Russia, children are taught not to smile for no reason. In fact, Russians are very friendly and always ready to help. They are used to showing other feelings only if they are truly sincere.
In general, all people in Russia are divided into types.
Those who like Moscow more, the business and official capital, and those who like St. Petersburg more, the cultural and historical capital.
But we can say absolutely for sure
that will you like the most?
Moscow.
St. Petersburg.
Having said about St. Petersburg, they cannot ignore the news that the Hermitage, together with Binance Exchange, they released a collection of NFT tokens. The collection of works includes such artists as Leonardo da Vinci, Giorgione, Van Gogh, Monet. The Hermitage Ledger service has developed a model for the creation and sale of NFT, which is fully consistent with Russian legislation.
Just think, this NFT collection will be created in a country where cryptocurrencies are almost completely banned. Thus, an important precedent has been created by Hermitage that will allow further integration of Russian market into the international turnover of NFT.
The Russian crypto community is very large and active. I think it is the biggest at the moment.
Open the Discord or Telegram chat of any project. I am sure that you will find a large number of Russian-speaking people there.
I participate in FritisNets, in which team members began to communicate in Russian with the community using online translator. And this is just amazing. Every day more and more content is being created in Russian. We already have a very large number of popular bloggers who every day created videos with product reviews, release armor with teams, or simply express their opinion on the state of the market.
Specialists from other countries have always been highly valued abroad, and they see the same situation in the crypto industry. Perhaps at least one person from Russia works in 90% of all crypto projects. In Near Network, half of the team is Russian. A project like OneInch was founded by Russians.
I think I cannot explain where the founder of Ethereum, Vitalik Buterin, came from.
So why are people so streaming for crypto and for decentralization? I think the point of that we love freedom very much. Yes, we know we have a strange political situation in the country, but you will never find people who love their freedom as much as we do. And it's simply not possible to keep our freedom within a frame.
Regarding the legislation built for crypto adoption, they are now far behind many countries. But I remember how once they are also very far behind in the implementation of internet networks.
If you come to our country now, you will be surprised to find out how much the internet speed is higher here than in Europe or in the USA. We say that Russians are slow starters, but fast drivers.
They live in a very strange time. Time of struggle and global change.
On the verge of economic evolution, and transition to the Web3, driving into the framework of displacement.
But at the same time, discovered for themselves that the boundaries of our communication and existence are erased. Right?
Right. Together we can change everything.